So this shirt dress is being made in, these dresses are generally quite loose fitting. The length that I'm making this dress is going to be about 46 inches. I'm keeping this 43 inches because I'm going to add like a yoke to the top of this. The shoulders are going to be, she's a 16 inch on the shoulders, so I'm going to do this 8.5. And then the armhole cut is not going to be very long because it's going to have a yoke added to the top of this. So the armhole, length of the armhole is 4.5 inches. And because Halima is wide on the shoulders and not very big on the chest area, I want to make it, don't want to make it too loose from the top. And it's just going to be like an A-line, but the A-line is going to finish from quite earlier up. So the bottom, even though I'm going to leave splits, the splits are just going to be straightforward splits. So the A-line shape is going to slightly go in on the waist, which is about 5 inches from the five and a half inches from the armhole, and then placing the tip of the tape measure, I'm just going to take it into a straight cut across, measuring about 10 inches from the 12 inches from the bottom of the hemline. So that's just going to be cut straight. So it's going to be really just closed off up to there, and then we're going to do like a small 10 inch splits on the sides of the dress. So cutting the yoke on this, I want to cut this on like a bias. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut this first of all in the width that I require, this bias piece. So about 18 inches I'm going to cut this. So after we've cut this straight, I've just cut this into a straight, like a triangle, not a triangle, like a rectangle. And now I'm going to create the yoke. So the way I'm going to do the yoke is going to be one of the sides of the gamiz is going to be a slightly angled effect like this, and that basically is that angled effect. This is the front of the shirt and that one is the back, and I'll be cutting an armhole . So the neckline is going to come sort of around here. That basically is going to be attached then. Like this to the neck over here, and we're going to have just a small slit in the neck just to make the buttonhole. And really that's where. Now part of this is going to get folded towards the back, so that really is going to be like a diagonal effect on the shoulder area. Now what I want to do is I want to highlight this, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a thin piping of like a contrasting colour, probably of the maroon, to inlay that with. And the sleeves, I've got to get some more material to make the sleeves because I've not enough material to make the sleeves, and I would prefer to make full length sleeves because that'll make short sleeves. Prefer to make the full sleeves, so I'm going to get normal just full length sleeves, probably with a roll up tab there just to sort of tab them up. Now the measurements for this neckline, I'm just going to go on to just explaining this. The measurements for this are, it's 8.5 inches going across the shoulder. The width of this piece is 8 inches by 9 inches, and is slightly curved from the side, and then it's got a cut for the neckline of 4 inches by 1.5 inches. So it's a 1.5 inch depth and 4 inches going up, giving a total neckline of, that gives a total neckline for 8, 12. It's going to give a total neckline of about 14 inches, 14, 15 inches, which is what we require. Now, if we wanted to extend the neckline just very slightly, then when we scare stitch on this, it will actually slightly increase. So this, the top piece of this is like biased, so when you come to sewing it, you have to apply just a little bit of ease to make sure that the sewing isn't stretching.